thank you very much for joining me here on Fooding Around New England, our Cape Cod edition here at All Cape Appliances on Route 28 in South Yarmouth, Cape Cod, Massachusetts. Today, of course, you're going to see that I am going to be cooking a particular dish that is called the puttanesca. And it's rather an unusual dish. Its origin, well, there's lots of misnomers about where it came from, what it means. But I'm going to do a variation of it. And of course, it's a Neapolitan variation, a Sicilian variation. We're going to try to do probably alla Riga puttanesca. And we're going to be using Riga tomatoes. And we want to thank Nito, who is the proprietor over at the Italian Gourmet on Route 28 in Falmouth, Massachusetts, for finding it for me. I saw it on the web, went to a fancy food show, found it there, and I said, I've got to have them. And I found out that they're a co-packer for many other tomatoes. And of course, you have to be very, very careful when you do buy the tomato. This tomato has to have an insignia on it. Of course, it's DOP. You're going to find it at the Italian Gourmet on Route 28. It's in the, if you remember, the Hearth and Kettle Shopping Center in Falmouth, Massachusetts. Lots of great products, lots of food that you will not find at any supermarket. And of course, one happens to be in the Riga tomatoes. And that's the San Marzano. And you're going to find them there at this Italian store. We're going to be doing the puttanesca with olives. We're going to have some anchovies. We'll do it with the capers, salt and pepper. I'm going to add a little bit of maybe some, well, I've got a chili sauce. Sometimes if you do the pepper flakes, this zings it immediately. And of course, we'll add maybe some roasted peppers to it and maybe some capicola. Why not? It's rather unusual dish. You can find the entire recipe, by the way, on our website at foodingaround.com. And we'll have that recipe on there. And of course, some links to the Italian Gourmet, so you can maybe pick up a can or two once you've tried it. I mean, you can actually spoon and eat this. I mean, it's so good. The tomatoes are San Marzano, and of course, that's the best you can get. But don't be fooled by not having the DOP or any kind of, well, they actually have it numbered. So when you buy the tomato, make sure it has all of the insignias for the San Marzano. I'm going to take a very short break, come back and show you other different variations of the bite. Make some oil. I'm going to do the oil with some garlic and add some capers and anchovies, one of Rick's favorites. I'll just add a couple of more anchovies just to make the dish a little better. And of course, my little touch will be artichokes. Of course, this happens to be for, if you're a lady of the night and you're doing a dish like this, you got to take a little extra time. I'll be back in 2 minutes to taste.
If you like Italian food, that's real Italian food. You know a lot goes into it, like the freshest ingredients, a treasure trove of time-tested family recipes, and a whole lot of patience. The best Italian flavors take time and care to come together. So when are you going to do all that? Well, relax. We've done it all for you. Alfredo Aiello Italian Foods have been one of Quincy, Massachusetts' best-kept secrets since 1967. And now with stores in Quincy, Norwell, and Canton, and online home delivery, well, the word's bound to get out. Now it's easier to get the best. Alfredo Aiello Italian Foods.
Ever shop for a new appliance and wonder,
is there anyone here who can help me?
At All Cape Maytag and Appliance, you'll discover how we can be price competitive with the big box stores and still give you more. More selection, a large showroom with all the big names, more confidence. All Cape Appliance knows how to personally help you find what you truly need. And more savings with free removal, free setup, and free double warranties. All Cape Maytag, Route 28 in South Yarmouth, will give you big box selection and better savings.
Well, welcome back to Fooding Around New England, our Cape Cod edition here at Old Cape Appliances on Route 28. And I am chopping the olives ready for my puttanesca. And the origin is various, well, various descriptions of it. A lot have to say that it is the ladies of the night who had moments that they could not dine or eat. Or guess what? They found out that they had to make it very quick, and that's one of the origins. And around the early 20th century, it actually became, one of the entrees on the Italian menu. And later in the 60s, it became so popular, every Italian restaurant had to have it on their menu. A little bit of olives. We're going to add some, we're going to get our range up a little bit so that we have our olive oil. We have going to put some garlic in there. We'll add the capers a little bit later. I'm going to be adding artichoke and some capicola this is hot, by the way. You do have to give it a little spice, you know, to kick up that energy that you might need after a nice dish of puttanesca. And we're going to maybe, for an appetizer, take some roasted peppers, some Italian bread, smother that with that, and maybe put some minced garlic on top, and maybe some little Parmesan cheese, throw that in the oven. Sounds good to me. By the way, if you are thinking about buying an appliance, Maytag, of course, is one of the stops here along Route 28. Not only for Maytag, but Amana, KitchenAid. You'll find many different products here for you to choose from. Ranges, dishwashers, microwaves, and of course, ovens and ranges and top ranges. I'm using a KitchenAid right now. And it makes it easy for you, especially the what they call the ceramic top that you can just wash immediately. And I'm a messy cook, but sometimes I've been known to. We might even stuff some of the mushrooms with a little bit of the artichoke and maybe add some little Parmesan cheese. You'll find these recipes on our website at foodingaround.com. And why not? You get onto that website, you can find out all about different kinds of products, as well as some of the information that I find, of course, in my search. We're going to take a very short break, come back, start our dish, and, of course, mangia. I'll be back in 2 minutes and to taste.
Ever shop for a new appliance and wonder,
is there anyone here who can help me?
At All Cape Maytag and Appliance, you'll discover how we can be price competitive with the big box stores and still give you more. More selection, a large showroom with all the big names, more confidence. All Cape Appliance knows how to personally help you find what you truly need, and more savings with free removal, free setup, and free double warranties. All Cape Maytag, Route 28 in South Yarmouth, will give you big box selection and better savings.
Well, thank you very much for coming back here to Fooding Around New England, our Cape Cod edition here at All Cape Appliances, home of the Maytag, of course. And you can get here 7 days a week, believe it or not, even on Sunday between 12 and 4. And we got to do our puttanesca, and I have the olive oil going as we talk. And at the same time, I am adding 2 cloves of garlic to it. And one of Chef Rick's favorite, of course, he happens to love capers. And we'll add a little of, maybe a couple of teaspoons of capers. And it just makes the dish a little better. It's kind of salty, but I have the low, believe it or not, they have low sodium capers. And I was surprised. This dish here, of course, originated back in the 19th, 20th century in Italy. And actually in Syracuse, in Italy. They made the dish for the particular reason the ladies of the night just didn't have the time to eat. And this was a hearty dish. It kept them invigorated and, of course, made it easier for them to take care of business as usual. We're going to be doing the dish. And as I mentioned to you before, I am making it just a little variations a la Riga with some Riga tomatoes. And if you ever happen to be, if you ever see the actually different tomatoes that they co-pack for, you might see them at the supermarket. Just read the label. And of course, when you go out to the supermarkets, please read the label. You don't realize how many different countries are making and sort of like giving a, well, I won't say a quasi product. But it's just that China gets involved, Turkey, Indonesia, and they can put the Italian flag on it. And you might think it's Italian, but please do read the label. I want to take my rings off, and there's an obvious reason. I love to, it's just that I love to squash tomatoes. And I'm going to do that here with these, because these are the, I mean, you can use these as perfume. if you want. And these are plum tomatoes, San Marzano. And of course, they're the Riga brand. But again, they're co-packers for many different other brands. Now, you put this in And we're going to put this into the olive oil, garlic, and just browning it enough so that it's not. You don't want to get too burnt. It will be sour. And I'm going to add maybe 3-4 tomatoes in it. Because remember, we're not going to do it for many people. Just a serving of 4. This would be perfect for it. And once we get all these tomatoes in there, you can. And again, you don't have to do them with the hands. You can crush them right here. You know, get them down to a nice pulp. But you still have to have the pulp. Please do have the pulp. And if you might want to add a little sauce to it from the tomato itself, that's okay too. And easy enough. Now this is going to be for a little dish or two. We cooked a pound of pasta, spaghetti, number 12, a little thick on the thick side. Because once we toss this with the anchovies, and it's going to be, it's going to be all-encompassing. And you want to have the pasta a little bit al dente, because you are going to be cooking it in the dish itself and then tossing it for your dish. Now, you can add a topping of either parsley or Parmigiana cheese, Pecorino Romano. You can add some artichokes to it to make it a little tasty, whatever you wish. And I'm going to be adding some capicola, which is the hot and spicy. This is a spicy dish, by the way. One thing I will be doing is, of course, just because my mama would like this, happens to be tomato paste. You gotta have it. I mean, not that you should have it, but I think it adds just a little bit of flavor. Remember, this is a zesty dish. It's not something that for the foolhardy. And if you like anchovies, you can add as many as you want. You have a variation. I mean, there's all kinds of variations. I'm going to add a little pepper to it and just make sure that we have actually a little bit of salt. We're going to add some oregano too at the last moment. Any dried herb, make sure you add it at the last moment. Depending on you, everything is up to the cook. By the way, if you happen to be on Cape Cod and you happen to be here on a Sunday, I do have a radio show on WXTK 951. It's right there on the screen from 10 a.m. to 11 a.m. We talk about food, we talk about restaurants, we talk about almost anything that comes up, festivals, food festivals, anything that actually involves food. I'm going to be tossing some olives in it just to, you know, get it going with the olives. You can use olives if you wish. Again, it depends on your taste. And this is enough, and I hate to say it, for two people. And you must have some bread with it. Oh, fantastic. If you make enough of the sauce, and keeping it just, you know, I'd say on a simmer, you know, about 135 degrees is simmer. We're going to take a very short break. It seems like we're taking breaks all the time. But I just do want to mention that we are at All Cape Appliances here at 860 Route 28 in the lovely town of South Yarmouth, Cape Cod, Massachusetts. I'll be back in 2 minutes and two taste.
If you like Italian food, that's real Italian food. You know a lot goes into it. Like the freshest ingredients, a treasure trove of time-tested family recipes, and a whole lot of patience. The best Italian flavors take time and care to come together. So when are you going to do all that? Well, relax. We've done it all for you. Alfredo Aiello Italian Foods have been one of Quincy, Massachusetts' best-kept secrets since 1967. And now with stores in Quincy, Norwell, and Canton, and online home delivery, well, the word's bound to get out. Now it's easier to get the best. Alfredo Aiello Italian Foods.
Ever shop for a new appliance and wonder,
is there anyone here who can help me?
At All Cape Maytag and Appliance, you'll discover how we can be price competitive with the big box stores and still give you more. More selection, a large showroom with all the big names, more confidence. All Cape Appliance knows how to personally help you find what you truly need, and more savings with free removal, free setup, and free double warranties. All Cape Maytag, Route 28 in South Yarmouth, will give you big box selection and better savings.
Well, thank you very much for coming back to Fooding Around New England with your host, John Regan. I'm eating an anchovy right now. So good. You know, and it's going to be part of this dish. We're doing puttanesca, and very special dish, by the way. My mother used to do it a lot, although she was not the lady of the night. She worked at night, though, unfortunately, at the Boston City Hospital, and she was quite the woman. And Mama used to make various dishes, and of course, she would do a macaroni, she would do the chickadillies, she would do all kinds of different kinds of dishes, and cook them the day before so that I would never go hungry, even at 2, 3, 4, 5 years old. Even my babysitters actually had a better time than I eating rather than taking care of me. So she would cook in the daytime for the evening meal because she had to work like a 4 to 11 shift. And it made it very difficult because, you know, when you're a child and you live in an apartment house in the Boston area, and I lived in a 6-story apartment, believe it or not, and we had 2 apartments on each floor. So I was able to learn a lot about international foods. And it happened to be that, you know, I had Armenians upstairs, I had Greeks, I had Italian, I had French, Filipino, we had Irish, we had German. So in my evening hours from 4 to 11, I was well fed by a lot of different families. So I learned a lot about food, and learned about, you know, about taste, actually, more like a taste. So we're getting this down, getting the anchovies, and I'm really crushing them because I don't want you to, when you bite into it, not just like I did. I mean, I just did one anchovy. But, you know, when you order pizza, and Chef Rick here at All Cape Appliances said, he orders anchovies on every pizza he orders. You know why? Nobody asks for a piece. And not a bad choice, by the way, when you have it. So if you are, by the way, in Falmouth, if you happen to be here in the Mid-Cape area, Lower Cape area, South Shore, there is a little Italian store located right in the heart of Falmouth. It's called the Italian Gourmet. It was called the Slice of Italy. Now they have all kinds of Italian products. And what they've actually done is they've gone beyond their means to search out some of the, exclusive Italian products you will not even find in the North End, believe it or not. Some of the candies, some of the pastas, some of the tomato sauces, some of the herbs, the spices. He has boar's meat there. He has cowboy steaks. I mean, it's just unbelievable. So you really, you know, have to make a trip there to Route 28. And it's just beyond the 99 on the right-hand side. You'll see a little shopping center there. And go in, tell Nedo that I sent you. You have to try the Riga tomatoes. They are good. And this is not an infomercial for them, by the way. Your choice. They have many other different brands there that are San Marzano with the same DPO and DOP and all the insignias on there. So this is the dish that is starting. Now, again, it's your choice. I mean, I'm going to add a little of oregano to it. We're coming almost to the end of it, and I just want to be sure that the flavors are there, just letting it simmer, and that's just basically what you have to do. Don't overcook it. And if you do, there's always juice from your tomatoes, no problem. Add a little more olive oil to it if you wish. Now, you don't have to use red pepper. There is a sauce out there, and I tell you, and I'm just saying, if you want to make this puttanesca for a hot dish, just a dab. I mean, you don't take any more than just a dab, please. I mean, this is not perfume. and you just add it to it, and you'll see that you've got that puttanesca taste, that little hot to keep you going. Yeah, you could do a bicycle ride around the Cape. No problem. I'm going to take a very short break, come back, and we're going to plate this and take some bread and some roasted tomatoes, roasted peppers, artichokes, mushrooms. I'm going to make a feast. I'll be back in 2 minutes and 2 tastes.
If you like Italian food, that's real Italian food, you know a lot goes into it. Like the freshest ingredients, a treasure trove of time-tested family recipes, and a whole lot of patience. The best Italian flavors take time and care to come together. So when are you going to do all that? Well, relax. We've done it all for you. Alfredo Aiello Italian Foods have been one of Quincy, Massachusetts' best-kept secrets since 1967. And now with stores in Quincy, Norwell, and Canton, and online home delivery, well, the word's bound to get out. Now it's easier to get the best. Alfredo Aiello Italian Foods.
Ever shop for a new appliance and wonder,
is there anyone here who can can help me?
At All Cape Maytag and Appliance, you'll discover how we can be price competitive with the big box stores and still give you more. More selection, a large showroom with all the big names, more confidence. All Cape Appliance knows how to personally help you find what you truly need, and more savings with free removal, free setup, and free double warranties. All Cape Maytag, Route 28 in South Yarmouth, will give you big box selection and better savings.
Well, thank you very much for joining me back here on Fooding Around New England, our Cape Cod edition. We happen to be at All Cape Appliances. We've been simmering away there. It's going to be so thick. And this happens to be a good dish, but I'm a meat guy, and not that I have to have it, but I'm going to be putting capicola in it, and as my mother would say, capicola. And I'm going to have that in there only because I just want to give it an extra flavor. And again, this is a spicy, spicy dish. So you can add anything that you like. Spices, spices, spices. More garlic if you wish. And you can omit the... A lot of recipes don't even call for Parmigiano or Reggiano. Any of the cheeses. But you can add it to it. You can add some peppers to it. Now, there's variations. Again, if you Google this and you see variations, you'll see some that don't actually use a pepper. I'm going to use it because I just want this a hearty dish. Because once you have this dish, you can work all night. And this is one of the dishes that I've enjoyed at various restaurants. You know, a lot of restaurants made this very popular in the 50s, 60s, especially during the 60s. It just became something that everybody said, well, you got to have it on your menu because you're going to draw people in just on that dish. And this is going to be on our website. I hope this draws you to my website, foodingaround.com. Again, a very, very hearty dish. And I said to my wife, well, maybe this I'll cook in 15 minutes. Well, as you see, it's taking just a little bit longer. But, you know, it's going to be so tasty. A good salad, you know, maybe some radicchio. You can have some salad greens, some light salad greens. I wouldn't go very heavy on it. As a side, not a side, but your beginning dish, or the ending, of course, after this tiramisu. You gotta have it, because it's nice and sweet. And I'm going to add my pasta. A puttanesca dish, and of course this has capicola, it has olives, it has garlic, olive oil, capers, anchovies. I did it all. I went to every country, Naples to Syracuse. And I added my capicola for an obvious reason, just to give it some taste, something to chew on other than the pasta. And I did this al dente. This is a number 12 pasta. And look for your pastas, by the way, made in Italy, because you'll see that golden color of the pastas. And this particular one happens to be very good. It is called the Rienzi brand. I buy it at the Stop and Shop. You can probably get it in any of the Stop and Shops. But again, it's your call on the pasta. I mean, you can make your own. Why not? I mean, but this is puttanesca. You're supposed to do this in 15 minutes. You're not going to do that. And if you'd like, you can put some artichokes on the side. Not that you have to have them. Now remember, these artichokes are very bland. They're in water. If you soak them in olive oil with garlic, you're just emulating what you have here in the dish, unfortunately. But this gives you just a little bit of a taste of something to break the spice. I mean, this is spice. I mean, once you taste this, it's spice. This alone, the spice sauce, and you'll find the recipe. And I'll give you the brand names and all that on my website. It's at www.foodingaround.com. You'll see it there. And don't forget to tune into our television shows, not just only here on Cape Cod, but Boston, Worcester, Providence. Just get onto our website. However, I'm going to list them right here, all of the stations that we're on, all throughout southern New England. You can watch our show, the times, and everything for you to enjoy. And don't forget to listen to our radio show, which is in southeastern Massachusetts. That happens to be on WXTK. That's in, southeastern Massachusetts, up to Attleboro, up to the Quincy border. You can listen to us on Sundays at 10 a.m. to 11 a.m. And our podcast, by the way, you can listen to all of our shows, all of our interviews at foodingaround.com. And if you want to find out more about our shows, where we're going to be, our appearances, our cooking shows, go on to johnrega.com, and simple enough, R-E-G-A, and you'll find out more about us. This is the puttanesca dish. I just want to add some more olives to it. And because, my family's from southern Italy, and of course, cheese is a very good thing to have. It is good for you, as always, and makes you healthy. And I think that's a nice little dish. And again, you can add a little bit, of course, roasted pepper if you'd like, just to give us some color. I think that's what, most of the people like when they see a dish. I'm just going to cut a little strips just around these edges. And you'll see that a lot of people love roasted peppers. Mm. Just a taste. Mm. So what we have here is a very colorful dish, puttanesca. Not in 15 minutes, unfortunately, but maybe 17 minutes. Well, thank you very much for coming to us here on Fooding Around New England, our Cape Cod edition, here at All Cape Appliances at 860 Route 28 in South Yarmouth, Massachusetts, Cape Cod. Mind you.